It's demo time. Now, I'm going to show you how you can build a plugin to extend Copilot using the Teams Toolkit extension in Visual Studio Code. I already have Visual Studio Code running GitHub code spaces open in this machine here. Like Rajesh said, all you need to build a plugin for Copilot is a RESTful API that follows OpenAPI specifications. For this demo, we are going to use a repairs API, which we have already built following the OpenAPI spec. So this is a Node API built using Express in GitHub code spaces. First, let's simply explore the API. To do that, I've set the breakpoint in the project already and started the debug configuration. So let's switch over to the Swagger UI. Like you can see, the repairs API supports basic create, update, list, and delete operations on the repairs entity. Let's explore this. Let's go ahead and look for all the repairs assigned to a maintenance staff member. When I do that, the breakpoint is hit in my project. And like you can see, the response is returned. And the response contains basic metadata about the repairs entity itself, like the ID, the description, the staff member to whom it's assigned to, and so on. That's it. This is a simple API, which we are now ready to convert into a plugin for the Copilot. To do that, we are going to switch over to the Teams Toolkit extension, which is right here. I'll say create a new app. And then from the new project dropdown, I'm going to say plugin for Copilot. I'm prompted to enter an OpenAPI spec that defines my API shape and form. I already have one created for our repairs API, so I'll reference that. Like you can now see, I'm also prompted to select the methods in my API that I want to expose as operations in my plugin. I only want list and create repairs as the two operations that my plugin should support, so I'll select those. Of course, I need a project folder location and a project name itself. And we are ready to go. Now, the new project is being created and opened in this new browser tab. Now, a plugin has two key components. Number one is the manifest file that defines the plugin's basic configuration and metadata. And number two are the adaptive cards, which define the UI using which users will interact with my plugin. Now, the cool thing here is, using the OpenAPI spec, which we just referenced a few seconds ago, the Toolkit extension has already created both the manifest file and adaptive cards for me automatically. So let's click into each of them and explore. First, the manifest file. Like I said, the manifest defines the basic metadata and configuration about my plugin, like the plugin name, the description, and all the operations we just exposed for our plugin. Now, plugins can also support authentication. So if your plugin supports auth, you can specify that in the manifest. Repairs API supports anonymous access, so I'll skip that step. Next, let's click into the adaptive cards. Like I said, adaptive cards define the UI using which users will interact with my plugin. Using the repairs API response parameters, Teams Toolkit extension has already created adaptive cards for me, which, of course, I can change. For instance, I'd like for this thumbnail image of the repair ID, repairs item, to be a bit larger. So I'll go ahead and make the change. And like you just saw, the changes are reflected in real time in the preview surface, making it super easy for me to make these changes. All right, so we made a couple of changes, and we are ready to test the plugin. To do that, we'll switch over to the debug configuration and then say launch in Copilot. When I do that, Copilot will be opened in Microsoft Teams, and my plugin will be sideloaded and made available for testing. So now we are ready to run a quick test. Now, Copilot will open in Microsoft Teams, and I can go ahead and test with a prompt to fetch the repairs that are assigned to a maintenance staff member. When I do that, the repairs API that we just specified in the manifest is being invoked, and the response from the API is being fetched and rendered in the form of both text and adaptive cards, which we designed in the toolkit. So there you have it. Awesome. So we just built a plugin using an existing API and have it already working in Copilot in Microsoft Teams. And we did all this with just a few steps in under 5 minutes. Go build these. Thank you.
Thank you, Archana. Awesome.